Good day. Greetings from Amsterdam. On behalf of ICA, the International Congress and Convention Association, it is my great pleasure to address the esteemed audience of ITNCM on the topic of statistics. I hope in the coming few minutes to be able to tell you about our statistical publications and about how ICA sees the market both in China and worldwide. In order to do so, I would like to share my screen with you to show you a few slides that I have prepared earlier. We think at ICA that statistics provide a valuable opportunity to profile your destination. It's not just about numbers, it's also about the message that statistics can tell, the message that statistics can speak about. So this is one of the angles that I'd like to discover with you together now. Before I can start telling you about ICA statistics, I first need to explain what you will find in the reports that we publish. Our organization focuses on a very specific segment of the meetings industry. We only hold information on what we call association meetings that rotate on a regular basis between at least three countries and attract at least 50 participants. What does this mean? It means that we do not include national meetings, so meetings that do not rotate. It means we do not include corporate meetings or governmental meetings, etc., etc. We only include association meetings that rotate. So when I'm going to show you the numbers and statistics later on, please bear this in mind, that this is the segment that we are exploring, and I will come back to that later. Now, ICA has been collecting information for a long time. I'm very happy that I have a quite large team of researchers doing full-time research on the database to make sure that the quality and quantity is maintained. And I'm proud to share with you that as of today, we have more than 20,000 unique rotating association meetings on file. All of these meetings, of course, have their own individual editions, the 2019 edition, the 2020 edition, etc. And in total, all these editions are now 250,000, 250,000. And all of these meetings are organized by 11,500 international associations. So it's quite an impressive and large database, which is ideal for making a statistical analysis like I'm about to share with you. I think we all remember the good old days back in 2019 when the world was normal, not the new normal, but just the old normal. And I would like to start the presentation by sharing with you the slides from the 2019 report. So the report that we published last year. What you would need to do for this slide is look at the second column on the right, where you will see the 2019 figures displayed. So back in 2019, the USA was number one country ranking with 934 meetings, followed by Germany with 714, etc. Now you will see that China PR in 2019 ranked very proudly number seven with 539 meetings. So a real fantastic performance. And something to be very proud of. So please check the other countries in the slides for a minute, so you have a good idea of where the competition and the fellow destinations are ranked. We do not only publish rankings based on number of meetings, we also make other types of analysis, like in this case, the size of the meetings. And this, I think, is a very informative slide, because many people in the industry still have a misconception that association meetings are necessarily very, very big. And I think that this pie chart demonstrates that that is not the case. Actually, 90% of all the meetings in our database are smaller than 1,000 people. So if you're really looking for the big, big meetings, like the 30,000 cardiologists or the 25,000 dentists meetings, you're only looking at 10% of the total. So that's good for you to know. Maybe the venue in your destination or your own venue maybe cannot accommodate 30,000 people at once, but that's not a problem to be an active and respected player in the association market, because there is plenty of business to be found, which is much, much smaller. Again, this is referring to 2019. What types of venues are used to accommodate association meetings? Again, sometimes a misconception. Many people believe that the majority of the meetings take place in designated conference centers. But as you can see from this slide, that is not the case. It's only 20%. 41% of all the meetings takes place in hotels with in-house meetings facilities, followed by universities with almost 30% of the market. So again, this tells a story. This can lead to discussions and maybe decisions on maybe to build more hotels with in-house meetings facilities, or to create a better relationship with your universities, if that's not already the case, because a lot of the meetings activity takes place in universities. Or it could be decided that more designated conference centers are needed. So lots of types of decisions can be based on reports such as this that have an impact on the infrastructure and on the destination. Another type of analysis that we do is we look at the subjects. All the meetings in our database have a specific description of what the meeting is about. What is the subject matter? And as you can see, the majority of the meetings in our database are related to medical sciences, 17%, followed by technology, science, education, etc. Now, again, this is an interesting angle, because I think many of you know that destinations usually are known, famous, respected for being a leader in a certain field. So if your destination is very strong in medical facilities, good hospitals, etc., then you have a good chance of attracting more medical meetings. But if your focus is more on economics or management, then you can see what lies ahead with regards to market potential. So for sure, our advice often is to destinations, consider the subjects of the meetings that you want to attract. See if there's a match with what's current and upcoming in your own destination. And finally, from the 2019 analysis, the registration fee, total expenditure, so the revenue streams. We have tried to make it clear as to how much revenue was gained in the various years. Because as you can see also in the previous slides, we never focus on 1 year alone. We always try to include the 10-year picture. So here you will see how the revenue streams have evolved over the last 10 years. And of course, this is very important information for any stakeholder who is interested to understand the economic value and impact of the association meetings activities. Now I'm going to this year, to 2020. Because we've just released our 2020 statistics report, because only in May of the following year are we able to present the picture of the previous year. So we've just 2 weeks ago published our 2020 report, and this is part of that report. Now, what I'm doing here is looking at the number of meetings that were supposed to take place in China PR in 2020, broken down by COVID status. What I've showed you so far was the information from the 2019 report. And for the past 10, 15, 20 years, our reports have always focused on rankings to see which destination is the most successful, broken down by different categories. Of course, for the year 2020, that did not make much sense. So what we decided to do as ICA was to not publish a ranking in 2020, but instead make it insightful to the audience as to how the meetings were affected that were supposed to take place. So in 2020, for China PR, you can see that 44% of the meetings were postponed. 23% of the meetings went virtual. Only 8% was unaffected. And I have a good feeling that those 8% meetings took place in the very early beginning of 2020, because later in the year, of course, hardly anything could take place anymore face to face. So this is a graphic that displays the situation specifically for China PR in 2020. And now I would like to take you to the global picture of the same category. And this is how it looks like in the report that we've just published. So globally, 44% of the meetings were postponed. 2% of the meetings went hybrid. 14% were canceled. 30% went virtual, etc. So you're now able to compare the percentages for China with the global percentages. And then you are able to draw your conclusions to see if China had a different experience of the pandemic, yes or no. Now, in the middle of the page, you will see the number of events that we were able to identify in for the 2020 report. 8,500 events are featured in the report for last year. This is a smaller number than we were able to identify for instance, 2019. But again, that makes sense, because for everybody involved, for as the research team within ICA, as well as the people who provide the information to us, so the destination marketing organizations, the convention bureaus, the venues, it was very difficult last year to get a good idea of the meetings activity in their destination. So it was much more difficult to report the information to us. But still, the percentages tell a very clear story. So it's still very valuable, even though it's a bit smaller than it was in previous years. But yeah, of course, last year was an exceptional year. Now, it's always good to look at the situation from more than one angle. So far, we have been looking at the number of events in a certain year, in a certain destination. Of course, it's also very interesting looking at the number of attendees, the number of delegates that come to these meetings or should have come to these meetings. And this is what you see here in this particular slide, the total number of attendees by the status. So be it postponed, be it canceled, etc. Totals to over 4 million. So 4 million potential attendees that should have visited all the association meetings in 2020, had to take a different direction. Because if a meeting is virtual, then you are not traveling and you're not meeting each other face to face. So the impact, of course, of the pandemic is very large indeed. And this number tells a very clear story. So far, we've looked at the situation specific for China PR. We've looked at the worldwide picture. This slide gives you an idea of how the various continents were affected by the pandemic. So Europe, Asia, North America, Latin America, etc. And then you can see some interesting differences. For instance, when I look at North America, I see that no less than 27% of all the meetings were canceled, which is the highest number looking at the other regions. So our friends in North America were quicker to decide to cancel the meeting rather than coming up with alternatives like postponing or going virtual. Of course, the pandemic came with a price in more than one aspect. And what we've done on this particular slide is show you to what amounts the various affected status of the meetings had an economic impact. So in 2019, the total revenue was 10 million plus. And you can see that, for instance, the volume effect by the lesser number of meetings, 8,500 compared to 2019, 12,500, so 4,000 meetings less, results in almost 4 million revenue loss. The number of canceled meetings result in almost 1 million revenue loss, etc. And then the final number for 2020 that remains, so what was the revenue for the association segment in 2020 was just over 1.5 million. Yeah. Now let's look at the little bit at the future and make a few predictions of what we think as ICA that could happen. This breakdown is by subject again, and more specifically how these meetings were affected. And what this picture shows is that, for instance, the medical meetings for 47% were postponed. And other segments, for instance, the technology segment, 48% of the meetings went virtual. So the number of meetings that went virtual is much higher in the technology sector than it is in the medical sector. This is for a good reason, of course. Certain types of meetings are difficult to accomplish on a virtual basis. Some types of meetings need to be carried out face to face if successfully. So it gives you a clear idea of what you can expect for, certainly for 2021, but probably also for 2022. For instance, looking at the technology sector, virtual meetings will be here to stay, and certainly in the form of hybrid, because I think that many meetings in the future will need to offer a face-to-face element and a hybrid element together. But maybe, or looking at this slide, the medical sector seems more inclined to really go back to face-to-face meetings if at all possible, because there is a bigger need to meet face-to-face. So this is a nice bridge to the future, I hope. May it be more positive than 2020. What I would now like to talk about quickly is, again, different angles of looking at a situation in a statistical sense. So let's imagine that in a certain year, your destination has not performed so well according to the ICA statistics. What we would then advise you is to investigate if maybe there are other ways of looking at the data. If you were not able to attract a large number of association meetings, maybe you were very successful in attracting many corporate meetings, or you did fantastically well in the national market for that year. If you would only look at what ICA can tell by its statistics publication, people would get the impression that maybe your destination was not so successful. So that's why we advise any destination, any country, any city to have their own statistics in place. Because only then are you able to counter the suggestion that is maybe created by a publication like ours. And you can say to your stakeholders, ICA is right when it comes to the number of association meetings, but what they cannot tell you is the other side of the coin and how successful we are with other segments. Or you can look at other angles, of course. Again, instead of the number of meetings, look at the number of delegates that you attracted. Maybe focus on a specific subject area. Or look at the, the relative picture. Maybe you're still not very high in the ranking. Maybe you're 132 in the global list, but maybe you have climbed 100 places compared to the previous year. So by all means, use that in your PR to make sure that you get the right message across, that you are doing well, that you are active. But by all means, like it says here on this slide, don't focus on the latest ICA rankings alone, but collect your own statistics. That's very important. We are very proud of what we do with the database, with the statistics, but we do give this advice to all our members and to all the destinations. Please collect your own statistics to make the picture complete and to be able to tell the right story. Collecting statistics is not easy. We know from a research point of view, from the people who submit the information to us, like the destination marketing organizations, the convention bureaus, the venues, they have a very difficult time to identify all the meetings activity in their destination. For instance, you can imagine that all the meetings activity in the small hotels, in the hospitals, or in the universities is not always easy to report or to identify. So we need to stand together when it comes to collecting statistics. And I sincerely hope that after this short presentation, you will be our future partner when it comes to collecting information. Please support your local destination marketing organization, your convention bureau, and let's work together on collecting all the meetings activity, which is of relevance, so we can work on the best possible ranking for China PR in the future, once the new normal is here. And I look forward to that. And I look forward to hopefully seeing you face to face in the near future. Thank you very much for your attention and have a wonderful show. Bye-bye.